Good man. Here we go, a little ride on the Garw Valley Railway, miniature railway.
No, it's a company called Rocco that do it, or Rocco. But the problem with Rocco is their little steam engines, they look perfect. They work lovely, but they have life expectancy. And once that life expectancy passes, don't try and fix them.
No.
Just sell them on eBay Spares and Repair.
Yeah.
Because you'll never get them. Never get them working again.
What sounds are you thinking
about? Yeah, I can't remember what someone's name is, but yes. Yeah. If you want me to stop anything anywhere for a photo, let me know.
No, it's okay.
Annie and Cloud all going down. Well, that's what they started out life as, those two little weird ones.
Kid when you said that.
Oh, the kid looked terrified. What,
I know, she looked at you with evil looks.
It's like, yeah, we're putting that together again, though.
Sending drivers halfway around South Wales.
Oh, there you are.
Well, anyway, look, don't let me hold you up.
No, well, that's helpful. I'm grand right now. Sort of thinking along.
Thank you very much.
With Mac and Corey, power different. It's got a diesel hydraulic setup and utilises a torque converter to enable a large amount of tractive effort and force in a very small frame with a mild sized power plant. You'll notice it's got a small wheelbase around tight corners and bends, which is necessary in industrial environments. And you'll also notice that we've got side hots, chain driven like a large bicycle. The chain drive allows you to have more tractive effort and continual pulling power as opposed to side rod variant locomotives. Because side rod locomotives, the power is variable, because with each stroke and you turn the wheel, you don't always have the power there on a continuous basis. So this allows you to have more pulling power. Unfortunately, one side effect is that the stopping power is not increased, so you have to drive these locos with more care, because they can pull more, but they can't. Stop them out, same amount as a rocket.
Thank you.
Here we are now, folks. We are inside one of the DMUs in the Garw Heritage Railway at Pontycumber. So we shall now take a walk through the DMU. As you may well notice, they all look like bus seats, more or less. The old-fashioned bus seats, as the guy says. And we shall take a quick little brief look through. There we are, and this door now heads down into the other carriage of the DMU. Now we should turn around now and head back up. Here we are, should return now back up the carriage. This is the DMU at Pontycumber, or the Garw Valley Railway Heritage Site. It's been an open day up here today. The weather has been excellent. The staff have been excellent. And yes, I've had quite a few photos up here. Not sure if we can quite see down over there. You even got a model railway down by here. As you may well notice. There you go for now. And here, by the way, folks, this is the cab of the DMU, which I was just filming. And now we shall depart. It bothers me.
Oh, the chest, is it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've had it.
The diesel.
I've got to bring it weak.
Yeah.
Thank you. Elvis leaving the building?
Yeah.
For the planet? I only got short legs and I can go quicker than that. Is it like Wile E. Coyote? They got 200 strokes a second. Thank you.
Concrete sleepers put down there. Nothing, no track, just yep. Three sleepers. That was a,
yep,
that
and
was
now we got yeah. Start, and soon will be the ending.
Oh,
we've
got the ending.
Are you staying up here for the.
No,
it's
a good start.
You're not.
Right.
Stopped again.